Hello, Thunder Wizards. Today I want to talk to you about how to unlock and release positive karma in your life. There is a way to tap into infinity in each given moment and allow that infinity to create what you experience as being positive karma. You know, we look at karma the same way we look at bad luck. There's good luck and bad luck. We have this experience that it's something that happens to us. You know, you've heard me go on and on about attacking victim mentality and how it doesn't serve you. I won't get into that. And you've heard me talk about how you create your own destiny in every single moment. That your destiny is not something that is put upon you by some being. You know, God doesn't give you his will, you know, like they say in church, you know, find out what is God's will for you. It doesn't work like that. That your destiny is the result of the actions and beliefs that you choose to take. Beliefs are an action, by the way. If you think that your beliefs have no impact on your karma, you are wrong. Your karma is not a result of the things that you do to other people. Karma is also a result of what you do to and with yourself. Every belief that you have, if you choose to believe that you are a victim, you are creating a karma that you must live out, and it will be a negative karma. If you choose to trust the universe and to believe that you are the one who is here to serve yourself, and by serving yourself, you serve others. If you believe that you deserve to experience extreme bliss and happiness in your life, you create in that moment a positive karma that has to be lived out later. So it's just the result of your actions. And again, beliefs are part of that. I want you to know that. And the reason why, here's why I stress that. It's important that you learn to take control of what you choose to believe and what you choose to invest in for yourself. I use words very carefully. So listen again to what I say. It's very important that you understand that you need to learn to take control of what you choose to believe and what you choose to do. We run this life, we have this experience that things are happening to us. And that is the illusion. If you want to know what the illusion of life on earth is, that's the illusion. The illusion that you don't have any choice, but you do. Jung said it perfectly. He said, you must become conscious of what is in the unconscious, otherwise, you will act out, I'm using my own words, you will act out on your unconsciousness and you will call it fate. What he's saying is that if you don't become consciously aware of all of the beliefs that you are choosing to indulge in at every moment, the actions that you take, the patterns that have formed your belief system and that program you. If you don't become conscious of all those things, then what will happen is that those programs will run you and you will think that it is fate. that it's God. And it's not. It's always you. Always you. When we think of positive karma, we think of people who are born into privileged families, born into a lot of money, born handsome, beautiful, healthy, you know, those people, yeah, they just have good luck and they think it just happens to them. Of course, that's not the case. Or that God has decided to bless these persons and to curse those persons. Doesn't work like that. Whatever somebody has in their life is a result of the actions that they've taken in previous lives. And if they have, in previous lives, chosen to take actions and chosen to create beliefs in themselves that allow them to stay open to the positive transformation of their soul, then they build up a reservoir of good karma. But it's really just, I wish I could explain it. Positive karma is nothing more than the natural result of living in the integrity of your soul. Living true to the integrity of your soul in the moment. And so what we're going to talk about tomorrow in the live Q&A is we're going to focus on how you can do that right now. How you can, in this moment, tap into infinite amounts of good karma and experience right here and right now the benefit of that. You know, it's one of the benefits that I have of having lived on this planet for 55 years is I now have enough time under my belt, an experience of living here, that I can look at people's lives and I can see how they got to where they are, whether it's a positive thing or a negative thing. I can see, you know, especially people that I've known since childhood. And one of the things that I do is I watch. Because wherever you're at this moment is the sum total of the actions that you've taken up till this point, which includes the beliefs that you choose to indulge in. And one of the hardest things that we have to do is to learn how to change what we believe. And to do that continuously. Listen, I come down hard on people who indulge in being a victim. I come down hard on that. But the reason for that is because I know how challenging it can be. That the easiest thing to do, you know somebody's lazy, by the way, if you have a victim mentality, if you're a racist, if you judge people, you're lazy. It's the easiest thing to do. Just stop. Just stop putting effort into your life, and what will automatically happen is that you will become pessimistic, you will stop trusting, and you will start judging others, and you will start blaming others and blaming circumstances. That's laziness. To be somebody who is positive, who takes advantage of what is being given to them every single moment, that takes active work sometimes. Sometimes the hardest thing to do is to choose to believe and to choose to take action, fearless action. Sometimes that's the, you know, that's why people commit suicide. That's why people just put a gun to their head and, you know, because they've given up. They've stopped choosing to live. I mean, literally, they've stopped choosing to live, but they've stopped choosing to do the work. So when you get paid to do a job, especially a labor job, you get paid for either, you know, the amount of work that you do or the amount of time that you spend doing something. You get paid for that. And life is no different. This is what the planet Saturn is all about. If you want to know what Saturn is all about, Saturn, you know, we might even say Saturn might be the most important planet. Because without Saturn, you would never build up any positive karma. Now, your experience of Saturn is when you go through challenging periods, when you have challenging things happen to you. And that is the judgment of Saturn. Saturn says that, you know, you need to learn from your experience. And pain is the greatest teacher. You know, we seek to avoid pain. You know, doing something to avoid pain, we are far more motivated to do that than anything else. And the whole lesson of Saturn, when Saturn has his thumb on you, you know, if you're going through tough times, you can't make any money, you're miserable, you've got emotional problems, marital problems, physical problems, Saturn has his thumb on you. And the more that you fight that by feeling sorry for yourself and having temper tantrums about it, you know, it just makes him push on you even harder. And what he's trying to get you to do is to go, okay, how can I look at this differently? How can I, what did I do to get myself here? You take responsibility. And then he takes his thumb off. He says, that's all I wanted you to do. Now figure it out. So tomorrow we're going to be talking about how to unlock the infinite positive karma that is working for you in the present moment. And understand that if, you know, maybe I've said this already, but if you're breathing and you're thinking clearly and you have food in the refrigerator and you have, you know, if you can say that you're going to wake up tomorrow and probably be okay, then you are living on huge amounts of positive karma that's available to you. Here's something that is the biggest tragedy of people who are victims, who indulge in a victim mentality, and especially people who choose to commit suicide. The biggest tragedy is not to be able to see in every moment the absolute privilege it is to be a human being. Now, you need to understand what I mean by that. I'm not saying that you need to be jumping up and down for joy when tragedy strikes and, you know, a loved one dies, or, you know, war breaks out, or, you know, you get sick, or, you know, something horrible happens. I'm not saying you need to jump up and down like an idiot when that happens. What I'm saying is that in order to even be given the opportunity to incarnate as a human being, in and of itself is the sign of incredibly abundant positive karma. The gods wish they could incarnate in physical form. They wish they could be human because of the tremendous opportunity for power and knowledge and growth, even in the mundane things that we do, walk around and go to the store and, you know, sit on the toilet and all that. You know, even in those mundane things, there is tremendous power. And we've talked about this. We live here in the ninth world of the nine worlds. I'm going to sneeze. Hang on. We live in the ninth of the nine worlds. And as such, this world that we live in, if you look here, imagine that the center of this is where we are. And all of these other branches here are all of the other eight worlds. And where do they all lead? Right here in the center. There's huge amounts of power there. We have access to all of that power, more so than the beings that live in these other realms, the gods. The gods, the giants, the elves, they don't have access to the kind of power that we have. And so just being given the opportunity to be born as a human is a tremendous, I was going to say responsibility, but what I mean is an unbelievable opportunity. Here's one of the benefits of meditation of any kind, whether it's mantra meditation, whether it's energy work like Qigong, yoga, or stillness meditation. One of the whole points and the benefits of that is to learn how to be in the moment, in the present moment. And if you're able to slow everything down, stop all of the chatter, thinking about the past or thinking about the future or who am I or what I want, and if you're able to stop that and focus on the power of the moment, all of a sudden infinity will unfold in front of you. And it's in that infinity that anything is possible. I've shared my experience with the mystical martial art that I practiced and was taught. And when I was learning, very early on, it might have even been the first few days I was learning, the student that I was working with, he was a student in the class, but he was my senior. He had been training longer than I had. He was teaching me how to strike with energy as opposed to strike with your muscles. And he was showing me how to do it. And I won't get into all of that, but apparently I tapped into it for a moment. And you heard this loud crack on his chest, and he goes, no, that was it. And I had something opened up for me, and I can't explain it, but because I chose to believe in what he was telling me, and because I chose to make the decision to flow into infinity for that moment, it's the best way I can describe it. Because of that, all of a sudden, the universe completely shifted. And for a split second, I knew that if I wanted to, I could walk through the wall. I knew it. There was no doubt in my mind. If I had acted on that in that frame of mind, I would have walked right through the wall. And as soon as I had that thought, then my rational mind jumped in and said, what are you talking about? That's crazy. And all of a sudden, it was like I heard this, and I was back into my physical body in, the limitation. I was like, whoa, how can I get back there? The great thing about it is that's what stimulated me to keep doing the practice so that I could get back there. And I did. I was able to get back to that place of infinity. And that was probably one of the most powerful lessons I learned from that art. When it comes to releasing positive karma, there is that opportunity of infinity that comes in front of you. And if you're able to walk into it, you'll tap into it. The trick is to be able to keep walking into that. This is what all these things are up here. Courses.thunderwizard.com, the Celestial Qigong. All of those things are practical ways to give you a visceral, physical ability to tap into that. Because then once you do that, then it's available to you all the time. You have to keep choosing to go there. It still takes effort, but it becomes simpler, becomes easier. So tomorrow we're going to be talking, I'm going to share with you how to tap into that infinite moment and to use that infinite moment for anything you can possibly imagine, but to, you know, give it something that we can really work towards is the idea of unlocking positive karma for you in the moment. How to release that positive karma in your life so that you can benefit positively from it. So for that, I want you to go up here to neo.thunderwizard.com. There are four tools that I recommend, not only to get the most out of my teaching, but to get the most out of life. And those four tools are laid out for you in neo.thunderwizard.com. First one is, you have to know what your destination is, meaning what your soul came here to do. So along this topic here, imagine that there's a point of light. That is your destination. That's the destination that your soul said, I'm going to incarnate as a human being and my highest experience will be whatever that is. And there's a point of light. And I am going to, the soul talking now, I am going to stay on a trajectory in that light. So imagine that as long as the light is shining on you, you are empowered. If you deviate from that light, imagine you lose the power. And you start to lose your energy and you lose your power. You get back into that beam of light. You're facing the direction, is that my destination? No, that is. Your destination hits you. Now you have this infinite power and you just follow that. Ideally, if we continue to follow that uninterruptedly, we live the perfect life for us, whatever that means. But that isn't always what happens. So the first thing is, for some people don't even know what that is. They don't even know what the destination of their soul is. So that's the first thing you need to do. That is in what I call find your perfect career. Career can be career. It can be what you do for money. But really what career is nowadays is when you know what your destiny is, then you automatically have access to that infinite power to take you there. But if you don't know what that is, then it's like you're floundering around and, you know, life can be extremely challenging. So this is how, you know, at the first step here, find your perfect career. When you find out what your true destiny is, just being yourself, you get paid for. Imagine that. Imagine living your life in such a way that the universe pays you to be your most authentic self. You know, I think about this a lot, especially recently, because my, you know, my life and my career has really come together for me in the past few years. And I got to tell you, you know, I had a typical work day today. This is part of my work right now. But I actually worked about 2 hours today. And those 2 hours consisted of me talking to people on the phone, lying on my bed in my underwear, talking to people on the phone. That was my work for today. Tomorrow, my work is going to be, I'm going to wake up whenever the hell I feel like. And my plan is to go surfing in the morning. And then to go and get a massage because it's, you know, my muscles need it. I'm going to go get a massage after that. And then I'm going to come home. I might take a nap. I might do some work. I might think of some projects. I'll do whatever the heck I feel like doing. And then I'm going to come on and do my 6:30 live question and answer video. And that's going to be my work day. That's what I do. This is, you know, I was thinking about it today. It's like, I really don't work. I mean, a lot of times I feel like, gosh, I'm so lazy. And then I went, oh, I just made a bunch of money. Because while all this is happening, sales, you know, I get emails of somebody bought this and somebody bought that. It's, you know, if you go up here to courses.thunderwizard.com, you'll see what it is. It's usually a video series that people buy or you know, something like that. So sitting around in my underwear watching Netflix, I make a lot of money. And I'm not, it's not because I found some like I invested in something or I, you know, found some way to hack into the something or other. And it's just because I am now living my authentic, true self. I'm aligned to that light of my destination, and I'm following it, which just means I'm just being my most authentic self. And the result of that is the universe pays me. That's the first step. That's what I mean by find your perfect career. Learn how to be yourself, and by your doing, just by being yourself, the universe is giving you all the money that you need. It's an amazing way to live. And you know, if I can just get over the fact that God, I didn't really do anything today. You know, I still have guilt about that. Gosh, I really should have done more today. But I really don't have to do that. That's the lesson for me. I just have to be my true self. That's where all of my success is. Same is true for you. That's the first one up here at neo.thunderwizard.com. The second one is, now that you know the destination, you see the light, and you're following that light, you need a vehicle to get you there. Sometimes knowing the destination isn't enough. Sometimes people need power. I know I did. They need power to be able to continuously take action towards that light. This is what I teach. I teach what I know. I teach celestial qigong. It's the most powerful energy practice that will tap you directly into the infinity of the universe. It will do a hell of a lot more than that, but I don't have time to tell you all the things it'll do. But it will give you the vehicle, that's what I call it. It'll give you the vehicle to and fuel your vehicle to get you to that point of light, which is your destination. The third thing that you need, since you know what your destination is, you have the vehicle to get you there, you need to know how to navigate. This is how you learn how to hack into the matrix. We do live in a matrix. It is an illusion. I prefer to call it like a virtual reality for the soul, because it's a real place, but it is virtual reality. And you have an avatar, which is the word avatar means that which has descended. You know, we see this movie about Avatar, and we think of an avatar as this thing in the black, and we go online to play a game and we have an avatar. But the word avatar was for the supreme divine consciousness that would incarnate into human flesh. And this is who Krishna is supposed to be, who the Buddha was supposed to be, who Rama, if you're a Hindu and you believe in Jesus, you believe that Jesus is an avatar. You are an avatar. You are an avatar of the infinite consciousness of the universe. I want you to soak that in. You're not just some tiny little soul that has this sin and the world. You're not that. You are this. You are the infinite. You are God Almighty. You are that in an avatar. My avatar is Michael William Denny. That's the avatar that the infinity has chosen to pretend to be in this life, through me. You are an avatar. So, as an avatar in this physical body that you've chosen to inhabit in this virtual reality, you are doing it in this matrix, this illusion that is made up of life force energy. That's why the second tool is so important, because the matrix is woven together with life force energy. So you need to be able to tap into life force energy to be able to what? Manipulate the matrix. So the third tool is what I call knowing the rules of the road, which is the five rules to master the matrix. If you understand that the matrix is like a computer program, it responds to commands. If you know what those commands are, like, you know, on my Apple here, I've got Apple, F and Apple whatever, Apple Q, you know, whatever it is, the commands to get my computer to do things. Otherwise, if I just sit there and I don't do anything, my computer won't do anything. But if I put commands in there, the software and the computer will respond to my commands. The matrix is just like that. It will respond to your commands, but you have to know what those commands are. You have to know what they are. There are five rules to master the matrix. If you know what they are, you can then get the matrix to respond positively to you. Okay, so that's the third tool. Fourth tool is what we're doing now. I wish that all I had to do was to here, watch this video, do this thing, and then it's all taken care of. But that's fortunately or unfortunately, that's not how it works. We have to have this interaction. We have to be a community. And so that is what we're going to do tomorrow night. We're going to have a live question and answer. And if you have been following my books, following my videos, and taking any of the courses or anything from courses.thunderwizard.com, then you get an opportunity to ask me in-depth questions on a very deep level. And it's like having a one-on-one with the master. If you knew, that's fine too. Show up, go to thunderwizard.com and sign up at the Manifestation Mastery course level. And what will happen is you get to have a front row seat to a master class. And you can listen to the questions that are coming from the students who've been doing this. And then you can hear my answer in depth, and it's an opportunity. So everybody's welcome to that. And I'm going to go and I'm going to answer in depth, more in depth than I do here on this channel. Because people have been doing this a while, have very intelligent, specific questions that then I can really get into depth with. And I have more of a one-on-one relationship with those people on that live Q&A. So that's the fourth one is, you know, we come together as a community. And we talk to each other, we bounce ideas off of each other. And when you have all four of those things, you know what your destination is, you're lined up to that beam of light that's taking you to your destination. You have the vehicle, which is connecting directly to the life force energy of the universe. And then you know how to navigate what the rules of the matrix are and how to stimulate the matrix to respond to you in a positive way that helps you to get what you want. And when you get involved in a community of people who are doing the same path and bounce off of them, you have all of the tools necessary. So that's what I recommend. Go to neo.thunderwizard.com. If you want to see all of my books and all of my DVDs and everything else, which I recommend, go to courses.thunderwizard.com. And of course, subscribe and hit the bell button. Okay, so I will see you tomorrow night. If this is after it's archived, still go there and sign up because we do these live Q&As. The in-depth master classes for manifestation every Thursday. That may change later, but every Thursday we have that, and it'll go for as long as it needs to go. There's enough people, I'll talk for 3 hours. It's all up to you. So that's it. Go to the links. I'll see you guys tomorrow.